What up, everybody? I'm J.R. Fox.
I'm Dakota Cole.
And this is
Raise the Bar.
And today we are doing our second video, and it is Eminem's Premonition intro? Premonition intro that we haven't heard yet. And we're going to dive right into it because we ain't got time to waste. We're busy, okay?
Yeah, really quick, before we get into the video, if you guys are brand new around here, make sure you subscribe. We post every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
We try
to be as consistent as possible. But every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, we try to get new videos out for you guys, and we react to various things. So, yeah, be sure to drop a like as well, and I'm just ready to get into it. So,
let's get into it. Let's go.
Nunny.
He just killed a girl.
Let's go. Right.
That's how you start an intro.
Yeah. So I guess this is what it is, huh? I think it's obvious. We ain't never gonna see eye to eye.
I love the suit that he's got. He's got like a suit with like a shovel.
Yeah.
Just chilling.
Oh. Beats hard.
They said my last album, I sounded bitter. No, I sound like a spitter. 90% of these hypocrites are trying to get rid of. But why would I get a chip on my shoulder? I was considered one time as the illest. Bitch, I'm still as fly as a sipper.
He said, no wonder you're mad. Look at them plaques, count them. Mm-hmm. He's like, all the shit he's accomplished in his career. It's like, no wonder you're fucking mad.
I like that. And he's still talking about, like, that chip that he's got on his shoulder, too.
Yeah.
To still, and to, like, hold that, like, the chip that he's got on his shoulder to, like, remain up there. So.
Yeah, he says nobody says shit about 2 Chainz or Tech N9ne. I think that's what he said.
Uh-huh.
Like, nobody says shit about them, and they've been here forever.
Yeah.
But they're hating on him, but you know why? It's because of all the plaques he's got. All the success he's gotten over the years, they just want to keep trying to take him down.
Yeah.
So, damn, okay, let's go in.
You're mad now, looking at them blacks, count them. I'm LL Cool J, bigger and deaf for that top. I sound like 4 mil when I put out a bad album. Revival flop came back and I scared the crap out of them.
Let's go.
Rolling Stone stars, I get 2.5 out of
pause, pump, pump. Sorry. double pumped it. Anyways, did he say that even when an album flops, he still makes 4 million off of it?
Yeah, I think that's what he says. I get 4 mil when I put out a bad album.
Because wasn't Revival one of the ones that...
Oh my god, that's fucking hard.
Yeah, that, I mean, it's like a low-key flex. Like,
yeah, it's like, hey, you guys might say Revival was trash, but look at this. I'm still fucking pumping.
I still made 4 mil off of it.
Yeah,
so, I mean,
Jesus,
man. Dude, that's just off the record, too. That's not shows, that's not merch, promotion, nothing. That's just the record. That is insane. Holy shit.
He can literally spit on the mic and sell it, and then...
Yeah,
like,
bro,
platinum.
Jesus, bro. All right, here we go.
Let's go.
Sorry, I just wanted to make sure I caught that right.
Crap bottom, but Rolling Stone stars, I get 2.5 out of 5, and I laugh out loud, because that's what they gave bad back in the day, which actually made me not feel as bad now, because if it happened to James, it can happen to Shady. They do the same shit to Brady. More people hate me than love me. This game will make you go crazy.
He says they do the same shit to Brady. Tom Brady?
Yeah.
Yeah, it says they love to hate or something like that.
Yeah, like... I don't know, it's true, like, I don't know, like, Tom Brady, like, love him or hate him, he's statistically, and you can even look at his statistics, like, he is the greatest quarterback of all time. I don't care what anybody says, you can't, like, even if you debate it, like, he has the records to prove it, he has everything literally to prove it, like, the numbers and the statistics don't lie, like, and he's basically saying, like, I think what he's saying is that greatness, with greatness, you're always going to have people who hate, no matter what, like, literally no matter what you do, people are going to hate you, so it's like...
Pisses me off, dude.
Yeah.
You can literally go out of your way, I mean, look at Michael Jackson. You know how famous Michael Jackson was?
Yeah.
All the things he did for people, like, children in hospitals, never brought cameras around to record anything, and he was just tortured his entire career until he died.
Yeah. Yeah, man. So, all right. Let's go.
Let's go. Since the Brady, more people hate me than love me. This game will make you go crazy. But the golf will be all okay. I was the G, the OAG. Once I was played in rotation in every radio station. They said I'm lyrically amazing, but I have nothing to say. But then when I put out Revival and I had something to say, they said that they hated the Awakening. I lose the race. I'm too tame. I get back. They say I'm too angry. I need to give me some drink. So I said, okay. You people don't know what you want.
I remember him talking about that, too. Like, when he dropped the tracklist for Revival, people already fucking hated it.
Yeah.
They didn't even hear the fucking music, and they already hated it because of a tracklist.
And he had something to say.
Like, yeah, and he had something to, like, exactly to say. And
people, get off his chest.
Yeah, and people just fucking hated on him for it. So it's like...
You're doing a song with Skylar Grey? Sucks. That's pretty much what everybody was saying.
Yeah, like, essentially. So it's like, okay, bro, whatever. Jesus.
You can't please everybody.
Okay.
Awake me, I lose the race. I'm too tame. I get back. They say I'm too angry. I need to give me some drink. So I should hook up with takey fans. Keep on pulling me one way. Haters pull me in another. Got more hooks in me than Swayze. About to pick up some weights and lift to my tattoo of Haley. Say stretches. They said I'm just the writer. I sound like a baby. I dish it out. I can't take it. But I take it. This shit back out and make it all bit out of shape. The shit's almost comical. Wait, real quick. People say that I can't take it, but he does. He just dishes it back out after he takes it. He's like, yeah. Okay, you're going to say that about me? Okay.
So it's like me saying something about you and you like taking it, but then you'd say it and like, so like if we did a diss track on each other and like I kind of hit you with the shot, but then you came back and like murdered me. It's like,
oh, he can't take it. He's sensitive. It's like, no.
Yeah. And then he like dishes it back out like better than I gave it to him. So it's like. Just, he's not getting upset. Like, and I even threw the first shot at him. So, like, how is he the victim here?
Yeah.
Like,
people do that with Eminem a lot,
too. Yeah, and it's like, okay, bro.
They'll sit there and run their mouth, and when Em finally says something back, they're like, oh, he just can't take any criticism.
Yeah, it's like, I think
fucking stupid.
Yeah, MGK said the big bad bully of the rap game can't take a fucking joke. I think that was the line. And it's like, okay, bro.
It's like, but you dissed him first.
Well, it's not even it, though. Like, you literally used Haley to do a press run. Like, it's different than, like, putting up a tweet. It's like, to do a press run on it, that is a completely different fucking story.
Bro, you dissed my daughter?
Yeah, okay, sorry, we're off topic.
Bringing the whole camp. Not really, like, I'm talking about lyrics. The hell do you think I am? Let's go. Nipples hard. Oh, man.
Jesus, man. He said...
Go ahead.
Yeah, no. He said, so they basically get told that they'll never be as good as they once were, but even if they were half as good as they were back then, they're still going to be better than you'll ever be in your whole fucking life, career, everything.
Yeah,
so
still half as good as you'll ever be.
That was hard as fuck. That was hard.
Let's go. As good as I was, I'm still twice as good as you'll ever be. Only way that you're ahead of me is alphabetically, because if you diss me, I'm coming after you with the letter V. Wait a minute. Oh, God. Oh, I'm coming after you. Like, I'm coming after you like the letter V, because you become before V on the alphabet.
All right. Yeah, I think we've reached the end of the track too. What a fucking time to stop it. Jesus.
Hold
man.
On. Let me just go back. Just see. Make sure we don't miss anything right at the end.
After you let the letter be, killing everything. Play this tune. It's your eulogy. It's your funeral. Prepare to die. This is music for you to be murdered by.
Oh, that was such a hard ass intro, bro.
Oh, bro.
He took that shovel, right? This his lyrical shovel. and he just. Right across my forehead,
man.
Buried me with this bar.
Jesus,
bro.
Dude.
That was fucking hard.
That whole song is fucking incredible.
I'm not gonna lie, that was pretty fire intro song. I'm gonna give that at least a 9.
Yeah.
Give it a 9.
No. Yeah. Like it's an 8 for me. 8.5 for me, but that shit was incredible.
Yeah.
That was great.
Let's go. That was dope.
Oh.
But if you like that, you know, Let us know. If you don't like it, let us know if we should either raise the bar or lower it. Tell us what you think it is. Keep chasing your dreams. Never give up. We have music down below. We have Instagram down below. We have Facebook down below. All you got to do is go like us or, you know, follow us, whatever you want to do. You can dislike us. I don't really care at this point. So,
yeah, I don't know. That's about it. I think you covered everything. So, yeah, we'll just catch you guys in the next video.
Peace. Peace out.